Hello everybody and welcome to this video. And in this video, I'm going to talk about GeForce Now. So as you know, at the end of July, Warface has announced in a news post that they are available in GeForce Now. In that specific short post, they have stated how you can start playing Warface on GeForce Now. And they have also written two very interesting sentences. No more worries about saving memory space. Time to enjoy fast-paced combat in Warface on maximum settings, even on low-end PCs. Those two sentences kinda sum up what GeForce Now is. But basically there is much more than this, for the good and for the bad. So let me start explaining you about GeForce Now. First of all, how do you download the app? I will leave you a link in the description to the official site of GeForce Now where you can download the app. After you enter to the link, under Windows PC, click the download button. After that, install GeForce Now on your computer and after that, sign in to your GeForce account. If you don't have one, you can open one absolutely for free. After you logged into your account, you are ready to go and you are ready to launch Warface. But before that, I would suggest you to test your streaming quality before you run the game. Click on the settings in GeForce Now and then click on Test Network. GeForce Now will automatically pick the closest server to you, so you don't need to change it. So as you see, I have tested my connection and I have more than 50 megabytes per second internet speed, 0 packet loss and about 70 ping. Which is not that good because I'm pretty far from GeForce Now servers. The higher the ping, the worse it is. I will explain it a little bit later in the game. So basically, in order to play Warface in GeForce Now, you will need two things. One, to live close to the GeForce Now server, and two, to have a good internet connection. If you have both of those things, you will be able to play Warface in GeForce Now with not a lot of problems. So whenever I pick Warface and click play, I can play, but first I have to wait. Why? Because I have the free membership of GeForce Now. What GeForce Now is basically doing, it's trying to connect me to one of their gaming rigs. The waiting time for a gaming rig is not that big, but the problem is that you can only play 1 hour straight. After you play more than 1 hour straight in the free membership, you'll be automatically kicked from the game. And then you will have to re-log in and wait again for a gaming rig. After the launcher turns on, you may see that you play from 0 to 10 milliseconds ping on the server you choose, but that's not really true, because you have to add up the time that you have to connect to the gaming rig of GeForce Now. So if my time to connect to GeForce Now servers is 70 milliseconds, so I play with a ping of 70. Or in other words, 70 milliseconds delay between mouse and keyboard and GeForce Now gaming rig. So after you are finally in the game and you finally can log into your account, there is another problem. If you are using Steam, sadly you cannot log in because there is no option. You can only play Warface on GeForce Now if you have my.com account. So my main account is on Steam, but I have another account that I don't have it on Steam and it's in my com. So let me log into it. After you logged into the launcher, you can click play and after that your game will start running. You don't have to download the game or install it because it's automatically installed in the gaming rig of GeForce Now. All you have to do is just press play. After that, just wait for the game to load as you would if you would run Warface from your computer. And after you load in, you are going to see that you are in the game. What changed? Two things. One, you are now playing on the highest graphics possible in the game. And two, you are now playing on GeForce Now gaming rig. So as long as your internet speed is good and the packet loss is very close to zero, you will see the game running at 60 FPS on the highest graphics possible. Now I've decided to try to play a little bit in the safe house to see how it goes. There is no lag for me at least in the game itself. But there is a lag between the keyboard and the mouse, and that's a big problem. You don't see that in the gameplay, but I will explain you now what is going to happen in the game. Just think for a second that you have an enemy, okay? You aim at this enemy and then you shoot it. At a normal PC, you shoot it, you kill it, or you shoot it, you damage it. On GeForce Now, this is not the case. I have about 70 milliseconds delay between my computer and gaming rig of GeForce Now. That means that every action I do on my keyboard or mouse will only appear on my screen after 70 milliseconds. Let me make it more simple for you to understand what I mean. So let's say I'm playing as a sniper against an engineer, and I want to shoot the engineer in order to kill him. Simple thought, right? But we are not aimbotters, therefore our scope is not on our enemies, so we have to aim. So let's say my scope is there and I have to aim on the engineer in order to kill him. So I move my mouse so the scope will be on the position of the enemy, and then I start to shoot. But the problem is that the enemy is already not there. He moved from that position that I was aiming at. So basically you don't hit anything. And then I try to fix my aim and the enemy moves again. And that will always happen if you use GeForce Now. If you play from your own PC, even if you play with high ping, you will still see that you hit the enemy. And the enemy will die after a small delay. And in GeForce Now that's a problem, because the enemy is constantly moving, so you basically hit nothing. Only if the enemy doesn't move at all, you can hit him without any problem. And that's the issue of GeForce Now, it is not suitable for competitive gameplay. It is suitable for something else, single player games with high graphics, that an average PC won't be able to play at 60 FPS. So in that case I would use GeForce Now, but not if I have to aim an enemy that is constantly moving. Just for you to know, I played couple of PvP games on GeForce Now, and I'm gonna tell you, it's unplayable. Maybe for you it will be playable with lower ping to the GeForce Now servers. But for me, it was a horrible game experience. And sadly, it's always going to be like that if GeForce Now servers are going to be far from me. So let me explain all the pros and all the cons of GeForce Now. As always, we start with the pros. So the first good thing about GeForce Now is that it's free and it's simple to use. All you have to do is download and install GeForce Now, then log into your GeForce account, and after that click play on any game you want to play. Very simple and very easy. The second good thing is that you don't have to download or install any game. The game is already downloaded and installed in the gaming rigs of GeForce Now. That saves you quite a lot of time. The third good thing is that it works on low-end PCs. And this is especially what GeForce Now is meant for those kind of computers. The minimum requirements to use GeForce Now is now on your screens. If you want, you can stop the video and check it out. But now let's continue with the pros. So good thing number 4 is that you always play with 60 FPS. If you have good and stable internet connection, you will be able to play the game at 60 FPS all time, which is giving you a huge advantage if you play with a low-end PC that doesn't have 60 FPS in game without GeForce Now. Number 5 is that you will always have maximum graphics in the game. GeForce Now gaming rigs are extremely strong, so you won't feel any frame drops, even if you play on the highest graphics possible. And the last good thing of GeForce Now is that it's good for single player games. In those kind of games, you don't care about the latency or competitive gameplay, you just care about seeing the beauty of the game. And if you have good and stable internet connection, GeForce Now will give you amazing experience in those kind of games. And now it's time to move and see the bad things of GeForce Now. So the first bad thing is that it requires good and stable internet connection. So if you thought you can play from Wi-Fi or your phone data, most likely that's not going to be a good idea. Playing with internet cable plugged into your PC will give you the best experience in GeForce Now. But that's not everything. If you want to play in GeForce Now, you must have 15 megabytes internet speed. And if you want to play on the highest quality, you will need more than 50 megabytes internet speed. And a lot of areas don't even have that high internet speed. The second bad thing about GeForce Now is that in the free membership, you must wait before playing. Currently, the waiting times are not that long because the service is not that popular. When more people will start using GeForce Now, you will have to wait longer before you can play your game. The third bad thing is also connected to the free membership of GeForce Now. You can only have 1 hour gaming sessions. If you play the game for 1 hour straight, you will be automatically kicked from the game. If you want to play the game more, it's possible, you can do that, but you will have to wait for a gaming rig again. And we all know the bummers when the game kicks you when you play Special Operation and you almost finished it. Cone number 4 is for those who want to upgrade their free membership. To do that, you will have to pay 5.49 euros per month. You will get couple of benefits like priority access for a gaming rig, extended session length and RTX on special games. But I myself don't think it's worth paying 5 euros equivalent to Warface Battle Pass every single month. Bad thing number 5 is that you cannot play Warface in GeForce Now if you have an account from Steam. You simply cannot log in to the game from the launcher from GeForce Now. The Steam option, at least for now, is not available. Cone number 6 is that GeForce Now only has servers in Europe and United States. So if you wanted to play from Asia, sadly you will have high latency or even you won't be able to play at all. Maybe in the future GeForce Now will put gaming rigs on Asia or in Africa or in South America. But currently only Europe and United States are available. Let's continue with the cones. Number 7. GeForce Now is bad for competitive or multiplayer games. Those kind of games require a fast reaction. Reaction that is only obtainable if you play the game itself from your computer. Playing those games with GeForce Now will make you play with bad results. And it's extremely not suggested. Cone number 8 is that if you want to play some kind of a paid game, you must own the game itself. If you want to play Assassin's Creed Odyssey, for example, you must buy it first and then you can play it from GeForce Now. And the last cone of GeForce Now is that it doesn't support all games. If you will want to play a game like GTA 5 or Red Dead Redemption 2, you won't be able to do it. Even if you have the games themselves, you won't be able to play them through GeForce Now, because it doesn't support them at the moment. Of course, GeForce Now is adding more games every single time, but it will never have all the games available. And that's basically all the things I have to explain about the GeForce Now, whether for Warface or whether for other games as well. I really hope this video was helpful for you guys. I worked really hard to make it, so make sure to smash that like button, subscribe if you are new, and I'll see ya guys later. See ya and bye bye.